top 50 outrageous moments. For the next hour, Best Damn's taking you on a ride. It's the top 50 outrageous moments in sports.
Revolution, get down. Revolution, get down. Revolution, get down. Don't treat me like I was born for nothing.
Bizarre, idiotic, unbelievable. These are the times that you said, holy from 50 to 1, we're counting down the most outrageous moments in sports. This is one Best Damn you'd be crazy to miss. Buckle up, it's Best Damn's top 50 outrageous moments in sports.
Revolution number one.
Number 50, praising Arizona.
This one will be from 43 yards out. It's got the accuracy. It's got the distance. Martin Gramatica, 15 for 19 this season. And he hurt himself leaping up and down. Oh,
he just strained his knee. He hyperextended his knee.
It's not his kicking knee. It's his planting leg,
which is even worse.
Number 49. Dude, you're getting it down.
Flying is out of
ball. Oh, my goodness. Look where Harris is. He's gone. That's unbelievable. Dell Harris out on the floor.
Number 48, Easy Rider.
Did not allow him to put it on the floor and get by.
Oh, are you kidding me? Playing of the decade. Playing of the decade. Look through that time and time again, Chad Hartman.
We got a feeling it right now.
Unbelievable.
Number 47, surfing the net.
And that's a pretty bunt. Somebody just fell out of the upper deck and landed on the screen right in front of us. He looks like he's okay. He's sitting up. This kid came tumbling right out of the upper deck.
Many years as I've been here, I don't think I've ever, seen that. Yeah, he's a lucky dude, I can tell you that. I mean, Michael, we just saw him. He come flying out of the upper deck. They'll take him back and check him out and make sure he's going to be all right.
Number 46, major letdown.
Doug Peterson to hold. The Cowboys will win.
Wait a minute.
Where was in the end zone? No one covered it. And Miami did. That could be a touchdown if Miami has covered it.
A Dallas player touched the ball, and then the Dolphins went on and recovered it. Someone touches the football here. Watch what happens. It's Leon Lett. No!
Oh, Lett, who is haunted by his Super Bowl misplay. And the ball goes into the end zone. They say it was touched at the one-yard line.
Not Leon Lett. Oh, my.
Number 45, Lions, the glitch in the wardrobe.
Grounder to first, Lions slide, beats the throw. Petrie doesn't like it. Did you see that? Get the dirt out and all of a sudden he unbuckled his pants and they fell down.
Number 44, foul ball.
Second, here's the pitch from Johnson. Something crossed home plate in the middle of Johnson's pitch, and I think it's a bird. There's white feathers all over the place. I think Johnson just hit a bird.
Number 43, on the horn.
Brooks with time, rifles, touchdown, Saints. And he pulls up the protective coating. Uh-oh. There's a new one.
He's got his own phone.
He had his phone.
He had his phone stashed in the end zone.
You know something? He's too good a football player.
You're right.
To lower himself to antics like this.
Number 42, stashed away.
Mike Piazza looks confused. Randy Marsh has called Piazza either interference. I don't know what they called right there. And they throw Bobby Valentine out of the game.
Give me that again.
Well, Bobby was thrown out on that catcher's interference call, and he's gone incognito. Sorry, Skip, we got you.
Number 41, Headhunter.
They can get a first down outside the three. Brooks.
Good pursuit by the Jets. They got him at the four. Now flags down. Here comes Turley falling out. And somebody, and now Turley throws the helmet.
All right, he's down. Now all of a sudden, from nowhere.
Whoa. Well, that's what happens.
Oh, yeah. Kyle Turley's just trying to protect his quarterback.
Damian Robinson is trying to dehorn the quarterback. Turley comes in to defend, and he's thrown out of the ball game.
And number 40, bad blood.
I want me some Michelle Cicely Tyson. He's a homo. Pow, baby. So I said, we're a simulation. Donkey ugly. Tyson ugly. He a homo. We my lips are saying natural. Michelle Cicely Tyson is a homo. Baby.
Anybody remember this? Volcano Man. Bang.
Yeah.
Oh. The devil, you like to ride. You ever done that?
Number 39, Tommy Boynton.
Oh. Shattered bat, and it catches Tommy Lasorda, who's coaching in the third base coach's box. He pops right back up, and he's all right.
All right, of course I'm all right. Didn't hurt me.
Number 38, helmet bang.
Bingham gets out. J.C. France trying to get out of his car. Bingham says,
what's up? This is not what you need. This is not what you need.
Neither one of these guys, small.
Yeah, that's a, I knew this was
obviously good. Some serious disagreement as to what went on the racetrack there. Corner worker standing by, the guy's down on the ground. I'm trying to break this up.
Hit him with the firebomb.
Number 37, do the Bartman.
Again in the air, got a left field line. Oh, yeah. Reaching into the stands and could get it, and he's livid with a fan.
That's awfully close to fan interference right there. The umpire's all over it. The umpire right down there, Mike Everett's on the play. If Alou has to reach into the stands, it's fair game for the fans to catch the ball. If the fan reaches out over the field, then it can be ruled fan interference.
There you see it again, the fan. There's a couple fans in there reaching out there to try to catch the ball. I'm surprised someone hasn't thrown that fan onto the field.
Number 36, all tied up.
That'll straighten those guys out.
Now, you have had...
Let him in! Let him into the box!
Whoa! All right.
Watch the lawsuit, Ty. Watch the lawsuit. Kevin Collins. He's broken up fights before, but not in the penalty box. I'm so happy that fan fell in.
Number 35, sausage party.
Watch Randall Simon. He swings at everything, including a hot dog. Watch him. Bang! And hot dog goes down. Randall Simon.
I learned that from the parrot.
Well, he's not getting the start tonight, and he swings at anything and everything. Is he okay? Is the hot dog already? Yeah, they got him off.
Actually, he took off two sausages because one went down, the other one tripped over.
Number 34, Chillmore Girls.
Myers, Alex, Mercedes, mad, furious, and grabs Myers, who throws the ball, and we have a fight. Myers ducks Marcinia for the right-hand cross. The Myers begin to leave the bench. Myers got fouled by Marciniak, who threw the ball at her. Marciniak went back at her, and Myers floored her with a right-hand cross. And this one's going to be ugly for the final 9:51.
Number 33, looking sharp.
Garcia going deep. Owens on this side. Just makes the catch. Touchdown.
Is that a pin?
Yeah. He had a pin in his sock, and he pulled it out and autographed the ball.
Who would even think of that?
Who would think of that? Terrell Owens would think of that.
That's a first.
Number 32, bringing down the house.
Hill puts it on the floor.
And stops, and he brought it down. He brought the whole goal down.
And you'll see the basket go straight down on his head.
And he got out in a hurry.
Oh, he's lucky.
Number 31, Izzy Crazy.
Oh, that pitch is a little inside. Alcantara turning around and he kicks Salazar. Izzy's going to take on the Red Baron. He wants to fight them all. Oh, my goodness. This is one of the most outrageous plays I've ever seen. He just kicked the cat.
And number 30, wrong answer.
He's sitting here. I'm supposed to be the franchise player, and we're in here talking about practice. I mean, listen, we're talking about practice. Not a game, not a game, not a game. We're talking about practice. Not a game. Not the game that I go out there and die for and play every game like it's my last. Not the game. We're talking about practice, man. I mean, how silly is that, man? We're talking about practice. I know I'm supposed to be there. I know I'm supposed to lead by example. I know that. And I'm not shoving it aside, you know, like it don't mean anything. I know it's important. I do. I honestly do. But we're talking about practice, man. What are we talking about? Practice? We're talking about practice, man. We're talking about practice. We're talking about practice. We ain't talking about the game. We're talking about practice, man. When you come in the arena and you see me play, don't you? You see me give everything I got, right? But we talking about practice right now. We talking about practice. Man, look, I hear you. It's funny to me too. I mean, it's strange to me too. But we talking about practice, man. We're not even talking about the game, the actual game, when it matters. We're talking about practice.
Now, is it possible, though, that from where he's coming from, if you practice, not you would be better, but your teammates?
How the hell can I make my teammates better by practicing?
Number 29, running from Mayer.
In right field, Tarasco going back to the track, to the wall. What happens here? He contends that a fan reaches up and touches it. But Richie Garcia says no. It's a home run. The contention by Tarasco is that the ball is descending and the fan touches it. He's right. He's right.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Oh, wow. Meanwhile, here's the kid receiving congratulations all around. He's affected, possibly the outcome of the game.
And maybe the series, Bob. Maybe the championship series.
Number 28, Karaoke Bar. Home runway.
There's a plane coming down onto the field, folks, right now. We got a crazy landing going on. Here it comes right onto the field, right behind the field. And it's on fire. No way did that just happen, folks. Can't believe what we just saw here.
Number 26, healing effect.
Steve McCartney just wailing on Tony Wilson, getting ready for the knockout blow. Wait a second! A woman has climbed into the ring and is hitting McCarthy over the head with a high-heeled shoe. That's Tony Wilson's mom! McCarthy has refused to continue this fight, and Tony Wilson is going to win this thing. Now that's what we call motherly love.
Number 25, this guy's nuts!
Just one foul so far. Jordan has been going at it most of the night. Tied at 71. Oh, and into the front wall. Oh, my goodness! Wilder just kicked the photographer. And the photographer is hurt, and down he goes.
Number 24, parking infraction.
And now Chanhol Park, with one on and one out, shows bunt. And he drops it again down beautifully. Belcher will field and tag him out. Second time that Park has moved the runner. And now some shoving, and a fight breaks out between Belcher and Park. And Park hits Belcher. And both benches will empty. Well, you have to believe that Belcher said something to Park. And it didn't take long for Belcher and Park to square off.
Number 23, bearing it all.
Well, I'll tell you, we've seen some great plays on the field tonight, but how you're going to see something off the field that's a classic here.
Follow the ball as it goes up the tunnel from the right side of your screen. Watch this fella jump out of the stands into the tunnel. He appears to be at least 10 feet off the ground, if not more.
This is a don't try this.
No, don't try this. Watch this. There he goes, off into space. He catches the ball, goes all the way down the tunnel, and folks, the guy's all right. He's back in his seat, but have broken both his ankles. There he is.
Number 22, anger management.
And Mikulic has been ejected. Joe Mikulic just ejected from the ball game, and he's really letting the field of power have it. He is all over him. Joe Mikulic diving into second base, trying to dig up the second base. He's got it, and he's going to do a Lou Piniella. He's going to show it to the field umpire. Joe Mikulic throws his cap, and now he throws second base into right field. And now Joe's going to go after the home plate umpire, and he's all over him as well, kicking rosin everywhere. So now he's covering the plate up full of dirt. Speaking of Lou Piniella, now bats go sailing into the field by, he's going to pour water all over home plate and make it all muddy. He's impersonating a catcher, slams a water bottle down on home plate. He is really going after it. Astros coach needs to get him out of there now.
Number 21, run for the Rosie.
Strange news from the Boston Marathon tonight. What was thought to be the women's winner was nothing more than a fake. Rosie Ruiz appeared to have won today's marathon, but it was later found out that she had merely stumbled in from the crowd onto the race course a half mile from the finish line. Ruiz had the media and marathon officials fooled for a while.
Rosie Ruiz?
Okay. I'm sorry.
Rosie Ruiz, the women's winner in the Boston Marathon today with a time of 2:31 and change. Now, we don't know how many seconds that is. It may be a new American record. Have you been doing a lot of heavy intervals?
Someone else asked me that. I'm not sure what intervals are. What are they?
Well, intervals are track workouts that are designed to make your speed improve dramatically. Is someone coaching you or advising you?
No, I advise myself.
Rosie Ruiz, the mystery woman winner. We missed her at all our checkpoints. She came through the finish in a fantastic 2:31. We have to confirm that time at this point. But she was way ahead of a world-class field here today in the Boston Marathon. Thank you, Rosie.
Thank you.
And number 20, ball sack.
Packers are out of timeouts. 30 seconds remaining.
They're not putting it down.
Favre. And now, whoa, what happened here?
Fan came, it's the Burger King guy.
What is going on?
For the fan on the field, he took the sack.
This is incredible. I think Fred tossed him the ball.
The guy came running onto the field, and when the ball was snapped and he caught it, I thought it was the ball.
I thought Brett tossed him the ball thinking it was somebody that they had stopped the play. The whistles had sounded. And unbelievable.
Number 19, Iron Mike.
I was going to rip his heart out. I'm the best ever. I'm the most brutal and vicious and most ruthless champion there's ever been. There's no one can stop me. Lynch is a conqueror. No, I'm Alexander. He's no Alexander. I'm the best ever. There's never been anybody ruthless. I'm Sonny Liston. I'm Jack Dempsey. There's no one like me. I'm from Nairclough. There's no one that can match me. My style is impetuous. My defense is impregnable. And I'm just ferocious. I want your heart. I want to eat your children. Praise be to Allah.
Are you saying now, Mike? Mike? All right, Steve, you guys could decipher that, and we'll move on from here.
Number 18, oh, what a night.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Back in the ballpark, and I'm sure glad, and I hope they don't let you people see what's going on here at Comiskey Park. One of the saddest sights I've ever seen in a ballpark in my life. This garbage of demolishing a record has turned into a fiasco.
Number 17, Marshall's Flaw.
Looking, Nas stops, throws, completes it to Kilmer up at the 30-yard line. Kilmer driving for the first down, loses the football. It's picked up by Jim Marshall, who's running the wrong way.
Number 16, H2O.
Folks, this is a water cannon that went off unexpectedly
What a mishap. It was obviously triggered, ignited by the fireworks display in introducing the Spurs here on opening night. Fans running for cover. Look at the power behind this thing. And this just destroyed a lot of hair. Let me tell you that, folks, right now.
Number 15, splitting hairs.
Childs keeps it back. Hardaway launches the three. Won't go. Rebound starts. Final seconds. And a foul. And there's a fight breaking out. A fight is broken out between Morning and Johnson. They're quickly separated. You look at the benches. No one coming off the benches. Someone's on the bottom of that pile. Jeff Van Gundy is on the bottom of the pile. Trying to drag his players away. Again, the players have proceeded on the benches. If Jeff Van Gundy, irate, something has really set him off.
Number 14, car alarm.
Kick me, punch me right here for everybody. Go home, kick me, and punch me.
Number 13, crashing Daytona.
Welcome back to Daytona.
It's the big one, gang. It's the big one. It's what we've all been fearing, this kind of racing is going to happen.
A horrible crash on the back straightaway that began when Tony Stewart got turned sideways against the backstretch wall number 20. Saw a puff of tire smoke, and then everything went.
I think that's what started. Somebody got back with Ward Burton off turn two.
That car is taking a whale of a ride, that 20 car is. It's getting hit. It's upside down. It's hit on its roof. On fire.
Number 12, you ought to know.
Well, we got a little thing going on here between Beat and C-Corp. As the fans are now getting involved, as O'Reilly is out into the stands, and this is going to be something. O'Reilly's into the stands fighting with a Ranger fan, and all the Bruins are going over. Gilbert is in there, Peter McNabb. They're all into the stand. McNabb's going up to grab somebody about seven or eight rows up.
You got to worry about a spectator.
Well, the Bruins are at a decided disadvantage, Fred, with those gates that somebody could get seriously hurt.
And number 11, oh, Carl, can you sing?
For the ramparts we watch with so gallantly streaming. And the Rockets, red flag.
Uh-oh.
The bombs bursting in air gave proof through the night that our flag was still there.
I'll make up for it now.
Oh, say does that star spangle free and the home of the brave.
Zimmer down now.
Now Rivera.
That ball's not even close.
You talk about looking for a reason.
Absolutely.
Oh, my goodness. Don Zimmer and Pedro Martinez. Oh.
That's awful.
Don Zimmer, a 72-year-old man, went into Pedro Martinez's face, and Pedro Martinez threw him down.
Number 9, Walnut.
Fly ball hit deep, right center field. McCray on his horse. Oh, he hit the wall! McCray, Hobby McCray, chasing a fly ball, just ran through the wall in right center field. He will see that replay for the next 100 years.
Number 8,
fly ball, right field deep. Canseco back to the track. Look it out. It is off his head, it looked like. And over the top. A home run. That looked like it hit Canseco on the top of the head. We'll have to check the replay.
It did.
It went over the fence. David Hall's laughing out there, so it must hit something funny. It's right there. It goes over the homer.
Look at this.
Number seven, Yankee Jam Bliss.
Delivers high five. Hits it right center field.
That's on.
It is.
Oh, Chris Jam Bliss has won the American League pennant for the New York Yankees. A thrilling, dramatic game with overtones of that great sixth game in the World Series a year ago, and then the seventh game too. What a way for the American League season to end. A spunky young Kansas City team. Look at them mob Chris Chandler. What a season he has had. What a series he has had.
And number six on Thin Ice.
Here's Ventura, RBI single in the first. Watch out. Look at this. And here we go again. Ivan took exception to the pitch.
Number four, Bo Crazy, folks.
Never allowed to throw the combination, the thing is going good for him.
He's just hammering Bo in close. Just hammering it. That was another low blow. Down goes Bo. That's it.
That's it. Great.
It's a disqualification.
It's time for someone to understand that you don't have to keep the rules in this business.
And now there's a fight in the ring that's been started by some of Bo's handlers who went after Lou Dubin. Somebody's going to get hurt in there. My microphone got knocked off my head.
Don't do it, son. Don't do
There's
that.
There's danger all over the place here. This is a very desperate situation. What are you doing? What are you doing, guys? What are you going to accomplish in there?
Look.
Now the fight has spread off the ring mat. Torch Foreman doing his best to stop it. Two more guys going into the ring.
Now the riot has spread to the far side of the ring. I see some people who are jumping on top of people at ringside and beating people with chairs. Impossible to imagine what's going to be done to restore order here.
And number three, the play.
He'll probably try to squib it, and he does. Ball comes loose, and the Bears have to get out of bounds. Rodgers along the sideline, another one. They're still in deep trouble at midfield. They tried to do a couple of... The ball is still loose as they get it to Rodgers. They give it back now to the 30. They're down to the 20. All the band is out on the field. He's going to go into the end zone. He's going into the end zone. Will it count? The Bears have scored, but the bands are out on the field. There were flags all over the place. Wait and see what happens. We don't know who won the game. We've heard no decision yet. Everybody's milling around on the field.
And the Bears have won. The Bears have won. Oh, my God. The most amazing, sensational, dramatic, heart-rending, exciting, thrilling finish in the history of college football.
Number two, an earful.
Good stiff jab.
That's the jab Mike didn't have in the first fight.
What happened here?
He got bit, I think.
Evander Holyfield, look out, he's
We're getting to see strange things happen in boxing.
Major controversy here in round three. A very angry Evander Holyfield now. A left hook.
You know, it's funny, Mike was having his best
round. He hit him again.
Mike Tyson has bit Evander Holyfield for the second time, and this is all out of war.
Keep your eye on Mike. See, Mike has just, see, look at him. You can see him. You can see him. There it is.
I can't believe what I'm seeing, fellas.
It's over. It's over. Bill Zane signaling that it's over. I think they've just about had enough. Tyson showing desperation and fighting Holyfield two times. Tyson's trying to get at Holyfield again, I believe. It is complete bedlam, and Tyson is just taking swipes at anybody in front of him.
I'm beginning more and more to believe Tyson is a confused individual.
And number one, Fan Man.
Bo taking command right now with the jab.
Someone is still...
And somebody in a parachute has just landed on the edge of the ring, has been pulled away by security guards. The fight has been brought to a halt. There's a massive melee at ringside as this fellow with a motorized parachute has landed right on top of spectators and officials at ringside. Right now, police are filing by me at ringside and grabbing this gentleman who has created a monstrosity of an interruption in the bout. His parachute has caught itself up on a row of ring lights. Now we're going to take a look at an earlier shot of the parachutist before he came down. There he was on the left of the ring. And let's see what happened as he approached ringside. There it is. He hung himself up right on the lights, as you see there. And his body landed on the ring apron right on top of a variety of people.
Well, this is the most bizarre thing I've ever seen at a prize fight. And I've seen a few
the things so dangerous about this. It wasn't only a parachute. He's got some motorized
exactly.
thing on there.
It's a heavy,
up a lot of people.
It's a heavy capsule under that parachute with a motorized attachment. There could have been a propeller there for all we know, George. And if nobody has been hurt, it will be a near miracle.
Doing an outrageous thing to get some publicity for himself. Just when you think you've seen everything. You know you haven't, and there'll be more crazy stuff to follow.
This guy is going to wind up in the slammer in Vegas tonight, and with doggone good reason.